going to start by removing side panels, front cowl, clutch guard, spare belt, and any other components that restrict access to front end hardware. Next, we're going to detach front suspension units. For easier suspension removal, relax the springs as much as possible prior to extraction. Unbolt stock ball joints from spindles and pop the ball joints free from the spindles. Detach pipe springs and move pipe for better tool access to the A-arm hardware if needed. Unbolt the upper A-arm mounts. Retrieve all hardware that must be reused for the slide cast arms from the stock arms. Pins, bolts, washers. See installation instructions for clarifications. After assembling the arm as shown in the exploded view of your installation instructions, make sure the logo on the arm faces forward and is right side up. Washers are to be placed as indicated in the exploded view of the assembly. Fasten the mounting bolts and check for any resistance in motion. The arm should pivot freely, but keep in mind that if they feel a little snug, they will break in. Prepare each ball joint with camber spacers, caster support plate, and adapter sleeve. Camber spacers can be set up to your liking and can be adjusted after installation if need be. The adapter sleeve position can also be set up to your liking and adjusted later on. See the recommended starting position section in your installation instructions for the RAS2 suspension setup equivalent. The ball joints should be centered in their travel. To do so, make sure they are level as shown in the ball joint installation section of your installation instructions after each adjustment. Finally, attach the ball joints to the ski spindles and fasten the nut with washer. By now, you've reattached your shocks and reassembled the rest of your sled. To make caster and camber adjustments, first unbolt the ball joint from the arm. Rotate caster forward or backward, and move camber spacers to the inside or outside as needed. Adjustment performance results can be seen in your installation instruction manual. Refasten ball joint once adjustments are finished so they are level, as previously mentioned. Installing this new setup may have affected your ski alignment. To check this, place a straight edge along the track as shown. Make sure your front end is sitting at a normal ride height, and point the skis as straight as possible. See the check toe section of your installation instructions for measurement specifications on ski alignment. Take your time on this step and measure multiple times to be sure that you are aligned. Improper alignment can cause darting and other handling problems. Check that all connections are snug and inspect all new hardware to catch any mistakes you may have made. Torque bolts to spec is defined in your machine's service manual. Grease your fittings to prevent damage to pins or bushings, and also provide quick and smooth movement during suspension responses.